Welcome to Teal House Farm on a very cold afternoon because tomorrow is D-Day, the big day. We've been working forward toward, working toward for the last 10 months. Woo, it's bright. It is super cold though. We are bringing in our sheep and one of our goats to the butcher tomorrow. This is our first year raising our own large livestock for meat, and it was definitely a learning experience, but I think they are ready to go. So the black one there is very pregnant. She's our dairy goat, excellent milker. And that's her fiance, boyfriend, husband, whatever you want to call him. And then we have this little white goat there who was from her last litter or set, whatever you want to call them. He's now about 10 months old. And then there are two sheep who are being shy inside the barn, which we bottle raised, bottle lambs, and raised them. And they are also about 10 months old. And they are all going tomorrow to then fill our freezer. All right, first things first though, because it's been so cold today, their water has already frozen. So we're gonna just fill up a pot here with hot water so we can melt the ice. Right now it's so frozen I couldn't even stomp on it to break it. So if you put some boiling water, some really hot water on top, should help us hopefully be able to break that ice for them, get them more drinking water. We actually saw yesterday that our local farm store has water heaters 50% off for water crops. So Sam is actually going to go get one tonight, which would be great because it's going to be in the negative temperatures this week. And the last 2 years, what we do is this, you know, 2-3 times a day, you just got to go out and get hot water on that. If it's too thick, to stomp on it, hot water on it so it thins the ice, and you stomp on it and then get to the bottom. So that'll be nice to have this chore off my list. So we're gonna get them some water and then we're gonna get the van set up. Here comes the part where I'm totally horrified by what my children have managed to do to the back of our van. Oh, I forgot about that cardboard. Hang on. Okay, moment of truth. Clean it up. Oh, I need to be able to fit three. I really thought I'd be able to get one sideways. It's always something stupid, isn't it? Like the difference of a couple inches. To make something that should be simple impossible. Drives me crazy. Ah, I can't get it. Can't get it. Going to have to get somebody with more muscles to get this out. Okay, we did it. 1, 2, 3. I think it's gonna be kind of tight as far as fitting them in, but it's not a very long drive to the butcher. We've used the large cages to transport full-size goats before, and these are still, you know, 10 months old, so they're not even full size, so they'll have to lay down, but they'll fit. So two sheep and a goat and a minivan and me. So now we just have to wait. We're gonna get up early tomorrow morning. Sam is gonna help me load everybody because I'm sure it's gonna be a little bit of a zoo trying to get that done. And then off we go. Okay, next morning, it's about 7 a.m. Sam is up in the living room somewhere. Oh, so it's a baby. And we're gonna go ahead and get those sheep loaded. I am not gonna be able to vlog it because it is still dark out and I do not have a camera that'll film at night. So, sorry. So, we're gonna load them and then we'll fast forward to in the van. Okay, we're ready. Yay. Two sheep and a goat. Let's go. Thank you. possible at the beginning of the year, raised our own meat animals, our own large livestock for our freezer. That's like such a cool accomplishment. It's also, it was kind of funny. So you pull up at the butcher shop, right? And they have like just a lineup of people dropping things off, because between 8 and 9 is when you drop off for the day. And it's all these like professional looking farmers, you know, like people with big dually trucks and big livestock trailers dropping off cattle or big hogs and things like that. And I'm in the middle of this lineup in this little Honda Odyssey. But it just goes to show you, if you choose the livestock that works best for your land and best for the equipment you do have, that you can still raise stuff for your family. You know, we could raise a cow or a couple of cows, but I would have no way to bring them to a butcher. Okay, I mean we have a truck, but we don't have any trailers. I don't have any large equipment. Just even feeding cattle, like, you gotta move big hay bales, you know, we can't. But with sheep and goats, you can use smaller square bales. We could fit them in the extra large dog kennels. We're able to fit them in the van with the seats down. So for where we are in life, then this is a really good match. So even if things seem impossible, sometimes it's just more about working around what you have to figure out what will work best for where you are, not necessarily what other people are doing.